The design industry is developing. More international firms are looking toward Qatar with getting the World Cup. The World Cup is bringing a lot of international attention to the country at this time. There'll be a lot of work to be done from all levels of communication, interior designs. When people talk about fashion design, it's also not just high fashion design, but it's the uniforms, the supply materials, everything that goes into putting on a world event. Design is core to that. On the cultural side, world events also bring forward the country's culture that is hosting the event. So with the development from the Qatar Museums Authority of the various museums in the country, there will be more museums. There are many more museums online to be opened up over the next few years also. So there's such a deep need for educated people in the realm of all the arts to be entering into those museums in various positions. The eyes of the world are looking toward Qatar, to what's being developed. So to have our graduates as core participants in that, from a local regional perspective on the design work that will be done, will be vital for the country to have a voice coming from within Qatar, looking and sharing outward to the world. So that's what we're looking at. Those are the sort of undercurrent changes that have been happening, looking forward to the future. The physical changes in Qatar are daily. You know, and anyone who drives around the city and experiences it from one visit to the next can see all the changes happening in the country, which means there are also other businesses opening, a lot of new opportunities for graduates. Al Jazeera is another significant entity in the country, again, with an international perspective and voice, where our students are going to work at Al Jazeera. So we had one alumni working with us internally in our communications area, doing amazing design work and publications and promotions. And when things were starting to shift in the region, and she was seeing Al Jazeera's role in that, she definitely wanted to move into Al Jazeera and start using her design abilities in that situation because her passion was there. So we see that our students have this interest and flexibility and desire to go and join groups in the country that really are going to give value to Qatar and the region and allow them to bring their ideas forward to fit with the companies. Last year was our 10th year of graduates. In those 10 years, we've graduated 320 students. Last year was our very first graduation of men, because 4 years previous to that, we started accepting young men into our program. And so now we have 6 male graduates and 300 and something female graduates out there in the country and in the region mainly, working as designers. So they're working in private industry, private practice. They're also working in the new developments of the various museums in the country, which is the Museum of Islamic Art and Mataf Museum of Contemporary Art, Arab Museum of Contemporary Art. And they're starting to develop their work as entrepreneurs. We have an area in our school where we have a director of design entrepreneurship. He works with our senior students and our alumni in helping them develop entrepreneurial projects. So they have businesses, they have fashion boutiques. One of our alumni, in fact, has started a fashion boutique where she then brings in our other fashion alumni, some of their collections to then be sold and distributed through her company. She does that in conjunction with bringing in brands from all over the world, so the students' work is being presented among high fashion, which is fantastic for our alumni. And so we help in those types of projects. We had another alumni in our graphic design program who was hired into a major architectural development company in the country and who was asked to be the liaison for external design companies from around the world to come in and do the design work. And at the time that happened, she said, I'm a designer, I want to do the design work. And so it's just shifting and supporting the development of a local indigenous design industry. So at that point, they gave her the opportunity to do that, and she ended up hiring 14 or 15 of our alumni into this design, in-house design group within a development company. So those types of things are happening in the country that we're very proud of. We're really proud of our alumni who are out there working in the design fields, but also in the various government and non-governmental kind of groups, because as having an undergraduate education, you do learn a profession and a direction to work, but you also have all the other skills, abilities, and knowledge to go into many different types of professions and supporting business endeavors. So we have our students working across the board. Bloomsbury joined with Qatar Foundation to start two entities. One publishes and the other one is a journal. So we've been very fortunate in our work in the university to match up with Bloomsbury. We started the first design journal from the region with Bloomsbury. That's now, it's an online journal and it's available for any international submission of design articles. And they don't need to just be, what's a great part of an online journal, and the experiment with this one is it doesn't have to just be text. It can be any type of submission, a photographic journal, a video log, anything that anyone would like to present to that journal to develop design research in the region, but from international perspectives also. So that's one part that we've done with Bloomsbury, which has been outstanding. Education City is a unique environment because of all the American universities that are sitting in Education City, and now also a French university and a university from England, and we're all bringing our top-ranked programs within our own discipline area to the mix. So there's the best thinkers in the world from the various universities here working together. And our students have the opportunity to cross-register in courses, so we're all on the same academic calendar, and the students are moving back and forth for elective classes or different types of general education classes. And then also beyond that, our students and our faculty work together on research projects. So we have a significant research mission within Education City, and we're working collaboratively on applying for research grants, on working on research projects, and it's among all the universities. And if you look deeply into the Qatar National Research Fund and what's been funded through their National Research Priority Project, NPRP, you see the range of projects that people are working on.